Out of these three switches, which one do you think is the most expensive? Trick question. Number one was the most expensive, but two and three were basically the same price. The switch that we will be reviewing today, though, is number three, the Dreamland Linears. Let's start with the spring. It has an actuation force of 45 grams and a ball mount force of 62 grams. Here's the interesting thing, it has an E-colored spring. That sounds cool and all, but guess what? When do I ever see the spring? Also, regarding the spring, it had a healthy amount of spring ping. Let's just say the first time I pressed the switch, I noticed it.
There's a switch.
For $90, it is $22.50, which is surprisingly cheap. Oh yeah, something else to note is shipping price. $30 shipping. What is that? Not to mention, but that's not even like overnight shipping, it's DHL shipping that takes an estimate of 4 to 6 days. Regarding the stem bubble, it was not looking too hot compared to other switches in its price range, and I could definitely feel the wobble. Also, the smoothness of the switch was not actually that bad when stock, but even after lubing, I had a little bit of scratch, but it wasn't really noticeable when I was typing fast. Some of you might be saying right now, wow, Fluffy Talent, you're really laying out these switches, and I bet you're also saying, subscribe to the Fluffy Talent YouTube channel and join my Discord, which is in the description. But in all honesty, despite those problems, I managed to overlook some of them for one key purpose: typing feel. If you look past the spring ping, you will see a pretty unique switch. The dual stage spring paired with a reinforced palm stem and a short travel time of 3.2 millimeters creates an interesting typing feel. The 62 gram spring doesn't really feel like a 62 gram spring. It feels lighter, which is probably due to the short travel time. Or maybe because it's not a 62 gram spring, but a 58 gram spring. So basically, two of the vendors of the Dreamland Linear switches had different spec sheets. So I messaged one of the vendors on Endland Keys, and he or she fixed the spec sheet. One thing that also makes this switch different is the short travel time. Usually a switch has a 4 millimeter travel time, making it a very fast short travel switch. Anyways, one thing that I found that was actually really good for these switches was gaming. The dual stage spring and the short bottom mount makes the keyboard turn quickly and gives it a sharp typing feel, which feels really good when gaming. Not to mention, but despite all the problems, I can't deny, but these switches sound hella good. Honestly, because these switches are really cheap, I would recommend just getting them because they feel really unique. And if you don't like them, you have a long pole stem that you can put in any other switch. Or you could just buy Aqua Cream Yellows. Okay, bye.